All right, I think we're about ready. All right, look up here. An acute angle is less than 90. If it is equal to 90 degrees, like this one, then that would be a right angle. If it's smaller than 90 degrees, it is called an acute angle. And of course, if it's bigger than 90 degrees, like that one, that would be called obtuse. So obtuse would look something like that. A right angle would look something like that. And an acute angle would be a little bit, if you want to do it individually. Is everybody clear with that? All right, next. The distance. Now, we've been doing this one forever, so here we go. Put your formula like so. What are my x's? Negative 3 and negative what? Negative 5. What are my y's? 4 and negative what? Negative 8. Is everybody clear so far? All right. This becomes a plus. What's 5 minus 3? What's 2 squared?
4.
Very good. Excellent. This becomes a plus. What's 8 plus 4? What's 12 times 12? So the answer that I want whenever we get to a test is going to be the square root of 140 what? Is everybody clear on this? You have to be able to do the distance formula. Now, we're going to come back to this one as soon as I finish the bell work, because there's another way of working backwards that I want to show you in a moment. But for right now, let's move on. A midpoint. Raise your hand if you can describe what a midpoint is. Yes, ma'am.
The middle of a line segment.
All right, it's the middle of a segment. Very good. So if you wanted to draw that, you would draw a segment and then find the middle by measuring it or folding your paper in half and then marking it. That half is equal to that half. And put an M there, and that M stands for midpoint. Very good. What is a segment bisector? Who wants to try that? Go ahead, Austin. Same thing. It cuts a segment in half. It bisects it. All right, very good. Angle bisector. Who can answer that one right there? What is an angle bisector? Anybody want to try? All right, that's close. I guess it could be a line, but generally speaking, it's a ray because it has an endpoint, which is the vertex. So it's a ray that cuts an angle into equal pieces or in half. Is everybody clear on that? The word half means they're equal. All right, any questions on today's bell work? Now keep in mind, all right, there was at least one person when I walked around that wasn't working on the bell work. So if I knock you down for the week from 25 to 20 points, I'll put a little log in there as to why. But you're expected to work when you come in and sit down. All right, put away your bell work, please. There are some key terms, but before we get to that, I said I wanted to revisit this problem. So on a new sheet of paper, I want you to write down these 2 points and then put down the distance. So copy everything you see that we did on the bell work for the distance formula. All right, now watch and listen. This is where it's going to be a little different. There are some jobs where you have to work backwards. For example, if you're a detective, you have to work backwards. You have to get all the evidence and try to figure out what happened, when it happened, who did it. Well, up here, let's say for today that they don't tell you what this number is. Now, instead of that, let's put an X there. And by the way, that number is called the domain, but it's also called the abscissa. Now, I'm not going to make you write that down, but just try to remember it. It's called the abscissa. The other one is called the ordinate. So you have the abscissa and the ordinate. Do you have this copy down?
Okay.
Okay. All right. Well, no, that's okay. I didn't really make you do that. All right. Put the distance formula. Put parentheses. supposed to be a negative, sorry. Thanks. All right, put a negative there. She's right. All right, now put equals the distance, square root of 148. Now, I need you to pay attention to this because this is going to be some math. All right, we're going to put the x's in the first parentheses like we always do. What are my x's right now? Excellent. Put that down. What are my y's? Please. What are my y's, guys? 4 and negative 8. Now look, you have to stay with the same pattern, okay? If you listen just a moment ago, we went forward. We said x and negative 5, and then someone tried to go negative 8 and then 4. You'll miss it if you do that. You have to be consistent, okay? So we went the first one to the first one, and now we're going to go the second one to the second one. Does everybody understand what I'm saying? All right, circle this and put a plus. Now we're going to go a little further, and I need you to pay attention to this. You see how both of these have a square root, this whole side and this whole side? We're going to square it, both of these, to get rid of that. Just stay with me, copy it down. What's going to happen is the square root is going to cancel with the square, and you're left with 148. The square root is going to cancel with the square, and you're left with this. Copy that down. I know this is new to you. Probably no one has ever shown you this, but sometimes on the EOC they make you work backwards. It's not hard. You can do it. You just had to see it before. All right, let's keep going. Draw your line, circle the x. We're trying to get x by itself, so we're going to subtract 144. Does anybody know where that 144 came from? 12 squared. Okay, so minus 144. Very good. So now I get x plus 5 quantity squared is equal to 4. Now before I go any further, we know what x should be. It's right here. So when I finish, x should be equal to what? Negative 3. So if I did it right, we better get negative 3. All right, let's keep moving. You see how this is a square? Now I want you to take the square root. It sounds ridiculous, but it is right. Cancel out the square root with the square, and you're left with x plus 5. Can anybody tell me what the square root of 4 is? So put 2. And what's the last thing I have to do now? Excellent. Subtract 5. You guys are really pretty good with this, and that gives me a negative 3. And that's what we knew it was, but I just changed the problem up to where we had to work backwards. Is everybody clear on this problem? Now, let me explain something to you. Do I think you'll be able to do one on your own right now? No. But when we get back on Tuesday, because you guys are off on Monday, I'm going to give you one like this, and then you use your paper and you pull it out, and you try to emulate what you saw here. It's going to work the same way. I want you to try to remember the steps and the patterns. And I got it right here from another class, so I'm going to throw this one away. All right, next. It's real important. Now, don't copy this down. Just listen, okay? Today's work deals with some stuff you will be able to understand, and then it deals with some abstract stuff, okay? And I said don't copy it down, but I think I do need you to put this point right here, and let's call it A. So draw that diagram. Now we have to give some coordinates for this point right here. So it's over so many and up so many. But here's where the abstract comes in. You're going to say it's over x1, we don't know, and it's up y1, we don't know. So this is abstract, it's not numbers. All right, now listen carefully. I want you to put a point right below this one on the x-axis. Say it again. Put a point right below this dot on the x-axis. Well, right below it is going to be here, and on the x-axis is there. Now put parentheses. This is on your work today. I'm trying to go over it with you. Now look here. Since we're dealing with abstracts, who can tell me, I actually had one student tell me this, how do I start from the origin and get to this point knowing that this point is x1, y1? Raise your hand if you think you have a clue. Yes, sir? Add x. Anybody else who has another idea? how far over and how far up do I go to get to this point? I'm going to say it again. How far over and how far up do I go to get to that point? Who can answer that question? Yes. Excellent. Now, even though she said that, let me explain it. And even after I explain it, some of you may still be lost. But you got to keep trying. So here we go. If this one was a 5, then you know you'd have to go over 5 because that's what the x is. We're going over the same amount. Well, this one is not 5. It's x1. So she's exactly right. You got to go over x1. And since you're not going up or down, it's 0. Is everybody clear so far? All right. If I ask you to find the distance from here to here, you could use the distance formula. That's what you were taught. But I think I told you, if it goes vertical, which one do you subtract? Do you subtract the x's or do you subtract the y's when it goes vertical? You subtract the y's. So simply put, you subtract those two. Who can give me an equation where I subtract those two? Y, say it again. y1 minus 0. And if I subtract 0, what's left? y1. Now, I know this is abstract, but let me explain why they're trying to get you to think abstractly. If I just teach you how to do problems without trying to get you to go beyond that, then you're kind of limited. By thinking abstractly, the goal is that one day you will be able to expand your thoughts, and maybe this year as well. So look up here. One last thing. If I have x1 plus x1 and x2 plus x1, can I add these two up? Are they like terms? Do they look alike?
Yes.
All right, so what do you think that would be? A lot of people say x1 squared. A lot of people say what? x2. I'm not sure how you want me to write that. Who else? She's saying 2x. Anybody else? All right, look here. Now, maybe this might be a little too far out there for you. But let's just change it up. What is one girlfriend plus another girlfriend? Trouble. It is. It's two girlfriends. So she's right. x1 plus x1 is actually 2x1. She left the 1 off, but she had the right idea. They're like terms, so you add the 1. There's a 1 here, by the way, and there's a 1 there. Is everybody with me so far? All right, next. Can I combine these two? Are they like terms? Is everybody clear on the like term idea? x1 plus x1 is what? 2x1. Very good job you did on that. All right, now you have classwork, and I'm going to stop talking now, but I will walk around and help you. Whatever you don't finish today, I'm sorry, I usually don't give you a lot of work, but I do want you to finish it over the break, and you do have Monday off. So copy this down first, and I'll walk around and help you.